We're asked to solve the proportion. 8 over 36 is equal to 10 over n. So we need to figure out what n is. And the easiest way to do this is to multiply both sides of this equation by both denominators. So if we multiply both sides of this equation by n, what do we get? So let's multiply it first by n. So if you multiply both sides first by n, and the whole purpose of doing that is so that this n in the denominator will cancel out with this n, which is essentially in the numerator. You could view this as n over 1. So if you do that, the left-hand side of our equation becomes 8 over 36 times n, or you could even view it as 8n over 36, because you could really view this as an n over 1, an n over 1. So the left-hand side becomes 8n over 36, and then that will be equal to 10 over n times n over 1. This n and that n cancel out, and you're left with 10 over 1, or just 10. Now we can multiply both sides of this equation. To really get rid of that 36 in the denominator, we can multiply both sides by 36, or you can imagine by 36 over 1. Either way, 36 over the 1 is the same thing as 36. This 36 cancels out with that 36, and the left-hand side, we have 8n, and on the right-hand side is equal to 10 times 36 is 360. Now to solve for n, we can just divide both sides of this equation by 8. So if you divide that side by 8 and that side by 8, the left-hand side, the 8s will cancel out, and you are left with n is equal to 360 divided by 8, and we can figure out what that actually is. 8 goes into 360. So 8 is divisible not into 3, it's divisible into 36 4 times. 4 times 8 is 32. Subtract. 6 minus 2 is 4. 3 minus 3 is nothing. Bring down the 0. 8 goes into 40 exactly 5 times. 5 times 8 is 40. And then you have no remainder. So n is equal to 360 over 8, which is the exact same thing, as 45. So going back to our original proportion, we now solve for n, and we know that 8 over 36 is the same exact thing, as 10 over 45.